My name is Ron Coulter.
And I'm Cheryl Coulter, and we attend Rolling Meadows campus.
I grew up in Cabrini Green. I grew up with an abusive dad. My family was not a family that one would quote as Christian.
I was born and raised in Chicago. I did not have a relationship with God. I knew of God. There were just a lot of things that I didn't know, wasn't serious about. Both of us, this is our second marriage. Mm-hmm. He had a daughter and I had a son. Neither one of us were saved.
She brought baggage from her first marriage. I brought baggage from my first marriage. And sometimes I would describe our relationship before Christ as at war. I had a copy prep business and I was doing business with Faith Temple Church. They had me do something called Bible tracts. I didn't know what a Bible tract was. One day I got this Bible tract that said, "Does it seem like God has forgotten you?" And all of a sudden I started to cry and I was like, yeah. I had made up my mind that life wasn't worth living. The business was struggling at that point when we didn't have the money to pay the rent. I didn't want to accept the fact that I'm going to lose everything that I've invested into this.
I didn't know what he was thinking, what he was planning on. I could just tell that something was going on that wasn't right.
I had made up my mind I was going to go pick Aisha up from school, drop her off at home, and drive my car into a tree as hard as I could. But before I did, I said, I got so angry after reading that Bible tract, I'm gonna call the bishop's wife. He said, you call her up and you cuss her out because she just got into your business and had you go through this emotional thing. And I called the church, asked for her by name, and I was getting ready to start, and all I could do was cry. And she said, Ron, I want you to shut that business down for now. Come up here. I went up there. She said, I'm gonna let you use one of my Bibles. And she said, I'm gonna put a marker in there. And she put it in the book of John. She said, I want you to start there. I read that and I was like, I never read anything like this. And I could not put that book down. I gave my life to the Lord that day in that office. I said, I'm yours. Do with me as you see fit.
He was reading that Bible every day, every night. And I do remember telling him, you become a holy roller if you want to, and I'll leave. He went to church one Sunday, and he came back, and he was telling me all about Bishop Moody and how he preached and everything. And I just thought, yeah, yeah. But I said to myself, you know what? I'm going to go to church and check out this Bishop Moody. And that's exactly what I did. And I had never heard anyone preach that way. And it just did something inside of me. And I remember there was one Sunday when I did get up and I walked down that aisle and did give my life to the Lord that day.
When we got saved, we took the word of God literally and we took it seriously. And it wasn't like overnight everything changed to perfect, but I had to learn.
Yeah, we learned over time that putting God in the center of our marriage mm-hmm. is what held us together and kept us together.
Now, we can't even tell you how many ministries we've done together since being saved.
I think Harvest was the second church, that we attended. And I felt this is where God wants us to be. And I didn't say anything to Ron, you know, to convince him, but he felt the same way I did. And so from that point, we became part of some of the ministries that they had. I'm a part of the card writing ministry. I was a part of a women's small group. They have so many outreach programs that you could never not have anything to do. There's a gospel song that says, you don't know like I know what the Lord has done for me. And I think about that off and on because of all the testimonies he's given us. To know of God is one thing, but to have a relationship with God and to see God move in your life, in our life, the way he did, mm-hmm. it was just tremendous and awesome.
When God's in control, I mean, really in control, You go with it. Just go with it. Because my way wasn't working, Cheryl's way wasn't working, but his way works all the time.